By now you've probably noticed that there's way more F2L cases than just the standard 41. Sometimes one of the pieces is just chilling in a slot that isn't its own. Now these are the cases beyond standard F2L and often called the advanced cases. The cool part though is that instead of taking both pieces out and then working with the pair that you have left, we can actually use the same intuition we built for standard F2L and take out the stuck piece in such a way that we immediately set up into an easy insert. Now some of these solutions are ridiculously fast, making them just as important as the standard cases. Now in this video, I'm gonna give you a system to easily identify and solve these cases, but because it is that easy, I want you to promise me one thing. Don't just memorize the information, but truly understand what you're doing. But yeah, if you haven't even learned the standard cases yet, watch that video first, will ya? Now to make it easy for you, this entire video, I will only be solving the blue-red pair. I'm first gonna talk about the cases where an edge is stuck in a slot it doesn't belong to. It doesn't matter what slot that is, as long as it's not its own. When white is facing to the side, you want to compare the front color of the edge, or when the edge is in the back color, to the top color of the corner. So if they do not match, like in this case right here, we have red and blue, we want to set it up into this easy insert where also the colors do not match. And there's two ways to do this. We can either have the corner in the position where if we bring the edge to the top layer, we have a three move insert and then take it out like this. Or alternatively, we can hide the corner by putting the edge in the top layer and then just bring it to the position where it needs to go. And this also sets up a three move insert in the top layer. Now, after setting up all of these easy inserts, we just want to continue and solve them into the correct slot like we learned before. However, if the front color of the edge matches the top color, we obviously want to build a pair. And the way to do this is really easy. We just want to hide the corner and bring the edge in the top layer. And now we can just move the edge next to the corner, which forms a pair. And we can just insert that as seen before. However, there's one exception. When both colors match and you hide the corner, but now white is facing to the bottom, you cannot form a pair this way, because if I bring the edge next to the corner, we don't form a pair, but instead set up this horrible case. So for those cases, I would say to just rotate and just work with this case, and now both colors do not match. So this case, we can just set up a three move insert and straight up insert it into the back. Now we're gonna look at the cases where the edge is stuck but white faces to the top. And to see what case we have, we just wanna see if we can form a pair by bringing the corner over the edge. So this is a pair right here. And if you have a pair, it is really easy because you just wanna take out the pair and then insert it into the slot where it belongs to. Or the other case is where the colors do not match and you have like this triple sexy case. And if you have a good edge, meaning that the colors of the edge are opposite to the center colors, you can just treat this as a triple sexy insert. So just putting the corner there and doing two inverse sexy sets up a pair, and you can just solve it into the slot where it belongs to. However, when you have a bad edge, I want you to move the corner away, but making sure it's not in the back, but still in the front. And because the edge is to the right, I'm gonna do a righty sledgehammer, which sets up a three move insert, and we can just solve that into the slot it belongs to. Now I'll give you a few examples for whenever an edge is stuck and applying all of the rules that I showed you. So first off, we have this case right here. So this forms a pair. So we can just take out the pair and then solve it in the slot where it belongs to. However, from this angle right here, once again, we have a pair. So we can just take it out from this angle right here and straight up cancel into solving it in the front like that. And then next up, we have this pair right here. So notice that the front color is red, top color is red as well. However, if I want to hide the corner and bring the edge up, I would have to bring white down. So we cannot form a pair from this angle. However, what we can do is either rotating, which allows me to set up a three move insert like that, or alternatively, and this is the better option, actually using F moves. So hiding the corner right now brings blue in the top layer, place it right here. And if I bring the corner back, we also form a three move insert. And this solution is better because as you saw, we don't have to rotate for this solution. So now we have this case in the back right here, and notice that we have a good edge. So we just want to treat it like a triple sexy case. So I'm going to do two back sexies, which sets up an easy insert, which we can solve in the front left. Next up, we have this case right here. So we have a bad edge right here. So we want to move the corner right here. Because the edge is to the left, you want to do a lefty sledge. And this sets up a three move insert above the slot where we're solving into. And then finally, we have this case right here. So we have blue on front, red on top. So we can either set up a three move insert like this, or with the corner right here, we can also do this right here. But alternatively, last solution is to drag the corner next to the edge and that forms a pair which you can insert in the front right. Now, if you want to see all of the cases and their solutions, you can check out the F2L PDF, which lets you set up each case and try out my recommended solutions. It is honestly the best way to practice this stuff. Now, a quick tip whenever you have a corner stuck case is that this time the edge is in the top layer, so rotating does affect edge orientation. So whenever you have a bad edge, it's usually better to first rotate, which now gives you a good edge, and you can work with a rotational solution that usually flows way better. When you have a flipped corner, you want to compare the top color of the edge to the side color of the corner. If these colors match, we want to build a pair, and if you're facing white, it's really easy because we just want to hide the edge and bring the corner over the edge, which forms a pair, and then you can solve it in the correct slot. However, if you're facing the color, we can just bring the color next to the edge and take it out as a pair, and then proceed to solve it in the slot it belongs to. Now, if the top color of the edge doesn't match the side color of the corner, when facing white, we simply want to put the edge in the back, and if we now take out the corner, we set up a 3-move insert. And if we're facing the color of the corner, we just want to bring the edge over the corner, and if we now take out the corner, we once again set up a 3-move insert. And for the last set of cases, we have the corner stuck with white facing to the bottom. Now we want to once again compare the front color of the corner to the top color of the edge. Now, if these colors are not matching, you know the deal by now. We want to set up into this easy insert. And we can do this in two ways. We can just hide the edge, which brings the corner in the top layer, so we can just bring it in position. So if we bring back the edge, we now have a 3-move insert. Or with the edge right here, notice that if I take out the corner right here, we also have a 3-move insert, and we can insert that right away. But when the colors are matching, so we have blue, blue, you can just treat the case like this insert right here, where we would do a sledge, which forms a 3-move insert. So we have matching colors right here, putting the edge in the back and doing a sledge sets up a 3-move insert, and we can just solve it like so. However, when we have this case in the back, it is actually better to start with an F prime, which sets up a 3-move insert, and push the corner next to the edge, which forms a pair right here. The reason being is that we can now just insert this pair with a U2 insert, and it is just fewer moves. Now I'm gonna give you some corner stuck examples. So for the first case, we have different colors on top. So I can just hide the edge, putting the corner in this position right here, which forms a 3-move insert. Or an alternative solution with the edge right here is taking out the corner like this, which forms a pair, which you can just solve like that. Then for this case, we have matching colors right here. So with the edge in the back, I could do a lefty sledge, which sets up this 3-move insert. However, a better solution, as we've seen, is starting with an F move, which builds this 3-move insert, creating that into a pair, and then just solving it straight in the back like that. Then we have this case right here. So we have red on the side, red on the top. So I can hide the edge, bring the corner over it, which forms this pair right here. And we can just straight up insert it in the back. Then we have different colors right here. So for this one, because we have a bad edge, I would suggest to just rotate first and then deal with this case right here. So we can just hide the edge, take out the corner, which forms this 3-move insert, and then just insert it in the back. And finally, there's one more group of cases, and that is when both pieces are stuck in slots that aren't their own. Good news though is you don't really need to learn them because they honestly kinda suck. In most cases, when you have, for example, two pieces stuck, you're better off doing something else first, which hopefully brings out both pieces and you can just work with them from there. But if you ever do find yourself stuck with one of these bad cases, just remember these two things. If both pieces are stuck in the same slot, just take them both out, but make sure they're separated, and then you can work from there. However, if both of the pieces are in different slots, you're super unlucky if this is like the only option you have, but just take out one of the pieces, and then you can work with the case you're presented with. For example, right here, doing that. So this is two steps and one of the worst cases you can get. And that's it, guys. Now you know how to solve every F2L case intuitively. In the next video, we're diving into the fundamentals, the real world decision making that ties everything together. Which pair to solve first, how to rotate, when to solve in the back, all of the habits that make the biggest difference long term. You will find that video in the F2L playlist on screen right now, together with a link to the best cube on the best cube store on this earth, thecubicle.com, and the bestest discount code of all time is, of course, CubeHead. I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.